California law is a little suspicious that once a year there's an epidemic that's going to spread around the world that's going to kill everybody. The World Health Organization and the United Nations always states, once again, that there's this virus that manifested itself always in Africa that's going to spread around the world and cause a global epidemic. Now again, last year it was Ebola, this year it's the Black Death, as they called it, the plague that ravaged the planet and literally destroyed Europe, killing millions of people in the medieval times and dark ages. Now this specific strain has manifested itself back in Africa. Now, look, Africa obviously is an impoverished continent, but remember this, the World Health Organization and all of these UN camps are all set up in these countries in Africa to prevent this kind of spread and this kind of disease. Because obviously, viruses, bacteria, disease can spread, especially when you have population that doesn't have the same kind of access as we do to certain utilities that they need. But even the locals in these countries distrust the World Health Organization, distrust the United Nations so much, that they don't even listen to their advice on what to do to stop the spreading from happening, because they say this, locals say that the plague or any of these other viruses didn't get here until they got here. Now this specific virus is the pneumonic plague, which gives you basically severe lung infection, and it's very contagious, very painful. You can cough on somebody and you can give them this virus. Now, it's killed over 130 people, obviously made thousands more sick. But at the same time, the locals distrust the United Nations, distrust the World Health Organization so much, they think that they're bringing it in. Now, keep this in mind. There's a shadow monarchy controlling our government, controlling the United Nations, the World Health Organization, and this shadow monarchy is evil, and where there's evil, there is death. Keep that in mind, and a depopulation agenda has always been part of the New World Order's agenda. So keep that in mind as I discuss this, because they are capable of creating diseases and viruses. If you don't believe that, look at our own country, the CIA. We all remember the Tuskegee experiment, literally giving black people syphilis. So the distrust in these countries are so extreme that even in Madagascar, there's a ceremony that they're not going to stop doing. That they will risk their lives. They don't care. They're not going to listen to them, but they're going to risk their lives. There's this ceremony, which I completely disagree with. I think it's quite awful. But what they do is they dig up dead bodies and they dance with them. And then they rebury them. It's a ceremony, I think it's called Fama Hamadina. Probably mispronounced. But what they do again, they dig up dead bodies of their friends or relatives. They do the salsa, the tango with them. And then they rebury them. Now obviously this is going to cause viruses. Obviously this is going to spread bacteria. But think about this, they distrust these UN camps, they distrust the World Health Organization so much that they're not going to stop doing it, they're going to risk their lives. Now, the World Health Organization isn't saying that this is the reason why this plague came into existence, that this is why it manifested itself. They're just saying that it's helping it spread the virus. Now, if this pneumonic plague, again, which is a severe lung infection, we cough on somebody and give it to them, and it can kill you, and it's the same virus that killed millions of people during the medieval times in Europe, then how come they haven't restricted travel to an extreme amount in these countries? Why haven't they restricted travel? Why isn't this more of a sense of urgency? And why is it once every year, there's some global epidemic that's going to kill millions of people? Why? Now, again, in these communities, in Africa, obviously, a lot of these countries are impoverished, but that's why the World Health Organization, UN, they're all set up there. But the locals distrust them so much, they say that it didn't happen until you got here. Just the same way, you know, even here in America, where a lot of parents distrust vaccines, saying, this made my kids sicker. They don't want the vaccine. Now, the mistrust from these locals in Africa are so extreme, again, that they've had these camps, they've had the World Health Organization there for a very long time, And you would think that the trust would increase a little bit. It's only went down the tubes. And the Shadow Monarchy, the New World Order, absolutely has a depopulation agenda. And I truly believe that they use Africa and these communities as guinea pigs. Because why, if it was such an extreme epidemic that could spread and kill millions of people, and it's contagious through the air, why haven't they restricted these areas to a much higher extreme extent? What, do they want the virus to spread? They want it to spread. And again, don't ever forget that the New World Order has a depopulation agenda. And again, once a year, it always originates in Africa and these communities where the World Health Organization, where these UN camps are set up. So no wonder you have this mistrust from the locals when they're still digging up the dead bodies and dancing with them, regardless of how awful that is. Risking their lives. And look, we're in evil times, and, you know, there's dark days ahead of us. All I know is that obviously there are plagues, there are viruses, there are sicknesses, but the people who are responsible for curing it, the people who are responsible for stopping its spread, only help it spread. Because the people who are running these institutions are evil and want to depopulate parts of the world. Simple and plain. And I think locals, even Africa, the same thing.